Experiment number 8. Validation of Hess law through experiments. The aims of the experiment are to determine enthalpy changes of an exothermic reaction carried out using two different pathways of getting from reactors A to product B, and to validate the Hess law by using a given system. In thermochemistry, Hess law is applied to determine the enthalpy of a process which cannot be done as a single reaction in the laboratory. Hess law states that regardless of the path taken in going from the initial state to the final state, delta H has the same value, or it is independent of the route. In this experiment, two different paths will be used to produce the same products from same reactants. Since both paths give the same products, according to the Hess law, sum of the enthalpy changes of the reactions of path 1 should be equal to the sum of the enthalpy changes of the reactions of path 2. The enthalpy change of a reaction can be calculated using this equation. Here, Q is heat exchanged. Heat exchanged of a reaction can be calculated using this equation. When doing this experiment, we assume that the calorimeter is insulated and water in the solution gains all the heat lost by the reaction and none is lost to the surrounding or to the calorimeter itself. Required chemicals for this experiment are 2M hydrochloric acid solution, 2M sodium hydroxide solution, sodium hydroxide pellets, and distilled water. Required equipment are beakers, measuring cylinder, glass rod, thermometer, stopwatch, spatula, and hot plate. For this experiment, we use the same experimental setup that we used to find the enthalpy of acid-base neutralization reactions. For the reaction A, add 125 ml of distilled water into the beaker in the experimental setup and measure the maximum temperature. Now add 10 grams of sodium hydroxide pellets to the beaker and measure the maximum temperature of the solution. For the reaction B, measure 125 ml of 2M hydrochloric solution and measure the maximum temperature of the solution. Now add the previously prepared sodium hydroxide solution to this hydrochloric solution and measure the temperature immediately. Record the temperature of the solution at each 30 seconds until the maximum temperature is reached. For the reaction C, measure the temperature of 125 ml of distilled water. Now, let's measure the temperature of 125 ml of 2M hydrochloric solution. Now, add 125 ml of distilled water into the hydrochloric solution and measure the maximum temperature. Then add 10 grams of sodium hydroxide pellets into this beaker and measure the temperature immediately. Measure the maximum temperature of the solution. To find the heat capacity of the beaker, add 100 milliliters of distilled water into this setup and measure the temperature. Now, measure the temperature of 100 milliliters of hot distilled water and then add this 100 milliliters of distilled water into the experimental setup which contains the water at room temperature and measure the temperature. Results of the experiments are tabulated in these slides. Calculations. First, calculate the heat exchange during each reaction. Then, calculate the enthalpy change of each reaction. As mentioned earlier, according to the Hess law, sum of the enthalpy changes of the reactions of path 1 should be equal to the sum of the enthalpy changes of the reactions of path 2. But when looking at these calculations, we can clearly see that the sum of the enthalpy changes of the reactions of path 1 is not equal to the sum of the enthalpy changes of the reactions of path 2. That means the calorimeter is not well insulated as we assumed earlier. Now, we have to calculate the heat capacity of the calorimeter. First, calculate the heat loss by hot water Q1 and heat absorbed by cold water Q2. Let's take the heat absorbed by calorimeter as QC. Here, CC is the heat capacity of the calorimeter. By using the obtained values from the above calculations, find the heat capacity of the calorimeter. Then, calculate the heat exchanged of each reactions using this equation. Now, calculate the enthalpy change of each reaction. After doing the calculations considering the heat capacity of the calorimeter, we can see that the sum of the enthalpy changes of the reactions of path 1 is nearly equal to the sum of the enthalpy changes of the reactions of path 2.